We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Deathstroke, issue 37. This is from the 2016 series. This is part 2 of the Arkham storyline, where Slade is in fact in Arkham Asylum, and he's starting to question what's really going on. This is written by Christopher Priest, pencils by Fernando Pasarin, inks by Jason Paz and Sean Parsons, Jeromy Cox and Carrie Strachan did colors, Willie Schubert letters, assistant editor was Andrea Shea. Alex Antone was the editor. Brian Cunningham, group editor. Tyler Kirkham and Arif Prianto did the cover. Francesco Mattina did the variant cover. I have the regular cover and I really like this one better. It's pretty messed up looking and it really fits the Arkham theme. Slade is waking up in Arkham and he has mentioned that he was off fighting aliens for 2 weeks. He doesn't really know how he got back or what's going on, but the doctors, specifically this Candace woman, is trying to explain to him that none of that happened. You weren't gone for 2 weeks fighting aliens. And he's like, yes, I was. And she says, well, then how did you get back? How did you get out? That sort of thing. But when he starts to try and explain to her how he got out, nothing seems to be right. He says he got out by manipulating the fire suppression system, but there is no fire suppression system. The building is like over 100 years old. When he goes down into the basement to try and show her where he and Devon got out, there's a brick wall there. And he says, well, obviously you've replaced it in the 2 weeks. And she said, no, you weren't gone at all. In fact, the building has been like this. And she starts addressing a lot of his issues while they're down there. His problems with his family, his interesting obsession with adolescence, how he had multiple relationships with teenage girls, including the one that killed herself in Deathstroke Annual 1, Tanya. And then, of course, she brings up Tara, who he exploited in order to try and kill the Teen Titans in the Judas contract, which is a really old storyline, but definitely worth reading. So while they're trying to discuss these things, he's trying to understand what's happening. And Willow and Jericho are trying to resolve some issues as well. Well, Rose and Willow are the kind of the different personalities within the same body. And Jericho's trying to understand what's going on with Rose. That's his sister. He wants her to be right in the head, obviously. And it seems like he thinks that she might be going crazy. And maybe she is, but Rose is explaining that her costume was designed by Willow and she's married this guy for convenience and things like that. We're trying to learn a little bit more about her. Wintergreen's trying to be helpful, but she does recognize that there is a little bit of a deception going on, and they're supposed to assassinate this woman that's going to be executed, and for some reason the assassination is supposed to happen at 9:22. Well, Rose is trying to be helpful when someone wearing the Deathstroke costume comes in and beats the crap out of her and kills this prisoner. And Willow is completely confused. And meanwhile, Deathstroke is starting to figure out that something funny is going on in Arkham. And he starts to realize that the beam that hit him and Devon may have been a little more than just a beam of light. And the alien abduction thing may have actually happened, but not the way he thinks it does. Now, since we don't really know what happened during that 2 weeks, we're kind of left wondering. The issue is actually a lot more interesting than I'm making it sound, because I'm trying to be a little bit vague as to some of the happenings here, because it's really well done and it makes you really want to go check out the next issue. So this storyline has been a lot of fun. It's very interesting to see Slade be confronted with his problems, even though he's really trying not to confront them. This was another fun issue. I would definitely recommend it. It's not an action issue, but it is a build-up issue. There is some action in here and there's some pretty gruesome violence, but it's definitely worth reading. There's a great twist ending that I think a lot of people will really find interesting, especially because the crux of the story takes place in Arkham, but the twist ending really kind of throws everything for a loop, and I think it's worth checking out. But that's just my take on it. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing so you don't miss future reviews, and we hope to see you on the next one.